Before I get real into it here in a minute, I would just like to take the time to say thank you and welcome to Mr. Mayor Cahill, Dr. Hershey, members of the school committee, the BHS faculty and staff, families, friends, the class of 2017. One more thing that I would like to add is that I want to say thank you to both my parents that are here today, because if it wasn't for them, I most certainly would not be here in front of all of you and be graduating with you. So please give them a round of the hand, please, too. Graduation, the day we all thought that could never come soon enough, has finally arrived. Today, we reflect on what we all as a class have achieved over these 4 short years. From our outstanding performances by those in the music department, going out and competing from state to state, to our unbeatable athletes who have taken and dominated on and off the field on numerous occasions. We have done all we can to represent the Panther pride of Beverly High School to the fullest extent possible. Since freshman year, we have all grown so much in such a small amount of time and have transformed into the people that we are today. We, as the class of 2017, stand before our much-beloved administrators, teachers, friends, and family on this day of graduation as both a reminder and a reflection on how hard they have worked to help shape and develop each and every one of us. And in doing so by graduating, we are the product of their hard work and effort of our families and teachers have spent to help prepare ourselves for whatever lies ahead of us. Since our very first day of school, we have all been together through absolutely everything leading up to this moment. The class of 2017 is like a family, guys. The people you see to the left and right of you are who have helped shape and influence you over these years and made you the person that you are today. These are the very same people who have and always will be there for you whenever and wherever you may need them. Remember the faces you see today and keep them in your heart throughout your journeys on the road to success. Finally, I want everyone here today to make a promise to at least one person from this class. I want you to make a promise that you will become successful in whatever it is you look to pursue. Today, make a binding promise to become the next pro athlete, to create the next best thing, to go on to college and get your degree, or simply just be a good friend and be a good neighbor or parent. And while I'm up here, as a friend and classmate, I want to make my promise to each and every one of you here today. Seeing as how this may be the very last time I get to see any one of you, so I'll say it now. I promise to each and every one of you that I will not stop until I achieve my goal in becoming one of the few Navy SEALs. And that no matter how many times my bones may break or however many times I may get shot down, the determination that I have and the motivation that this class gives me will keep me alive and breathing. From this day forward, we will all carry Panther pride wherever we may go. Let the promise you make today drive you further and further into reaching your future goals and creating your legacy of success. I wish nothing but the best for each and every one of you, and I truly believe that you will all reach your goals and life of success. The only thing that will prevent you from getting to where you want to be is you yourself. I love you all, and I wish nothing but the best for you. Thank you.
First off, I wanted to thank all of the BHS administrators and teachers, especially our advisors, Mrs. Richardson and Mrs. Flaherty, for planning and hosting such a great graduation ceremony today. I also wanted to thank my parents, because without them, I wouldn't be the kid standing in front of you today giving this speech. And for those of you who do know the kid standing in front of you today, you'll know I'm more of a writer than a speaker, so bear with me. Now, I have a question for everybody. Have you ever been driving in a car down a highway and you just see something up ahead, something that catches your eye, whether it's a building, a tree, a sign, something that makes you want a closer look? And so you're driving down the highway and you can see it getting closer and closer, whatever's up ahead. And then as soon as your car reaches it and you go to look and see it, you zoom right by it and it's already behind you. For me, that highway has been high school, and that something up ahead has been my senior year. This past school year has been looming up ahead of me since my freshman year, and now that I've finally reached it, it feels like I've zoomed right by it. It felt like we started school last week, and look where we are today. It's honestly crazy that I'm finally here at my own high school graduation, and it's even crazier that I'm giving a speech to all of you. Way back at the beginning of high school, I think it was my freshman year, I read a quote from Steve Jobs that stuck with me. It read, "You can't connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backward. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future." Now, I think I speak for every one of my classmates when I say high school has been a crazy, crazy, crazy time. Over the past 4 years, we've all been through some high highs, and we've definitely been through some low lows. But we've kept it moving, and we're sitting here today. But I think that all those highs and lows and everything in between have just been dots we've been connecting in our own lives, important dots. Dots that have made us who we are today and who we're going to be. But I'm not going to stand here and act like I have all this knowledge and wisdom. I'm 18 years old. I don't know or understand how my dots have connected or why they have, and I'm sure none of us do. But I mean it when I say this. I really trust that in 1 year or 5 years or 15 or 20, we're going to look back and realize that all of our dots connected in a correct way, and we left a beautiful picture behind us here at Beverly. And now in the fall, I'll be going off to college. I know a lot of my classmates will be too. A lot of my classmates will also be joining the military, and some will be entering the workforce. Whatever road you are taking, all it is more dots to connect. And a lot of them probably won't make sense, but you've got to know that everything is going to connect in the end. Because that's when you can truly follow your heart and live in the moment. High school has been the time of my life. I know there's the whole cliche of, oh, I can't wait to get out of high school, can't wait to leave it behind me. But I don't buy it. Beverly is special. The people are special. The teachers, the coaches, the community is special. And the class of 2017 is special. And our time here is almost up. But I would be a fool if I didn't take a moment to appreciate everything that has come from my high school experience. To my teachers, I want to thank you for dedicating yourselves to my learning and for making me want to do the same with my own life. To my classmates, I love all of you. We survived this together, and I wish you all the best in the future. To my best friends, I can't express how grateful I am to have had my life impacted by each and every one of you. And finally, to Beverly and BHS as a whole, thank you for being the place where I felt I truly belong. Thank you.
Good afternoon, soon-to-be graduates of the Beverly High School class of 2017, and congratulations. I've heard it said that it can be a blessing to live in interesting times. Well, class of 2017, you are living in interesting times. In many, many exciting and wonderful ways, and also in some more challenging ways. There are cancers and other diseases that still need cures. Climate change is real, and it's here. And my generation will need your help in addressing these and other challenges. 200 some years ago, slavery was our country's shame. And a Beverly native, Nathan Dane, yes, Nathan Dane that Beverly named a street and a beach after, He did something amazing. Perhaps not fully appreciated at the time, serving the North Shore in the United States Congress, Nathan Dane helped to write a law known as the Northwest Ordinance that, among other things, outlawed slavery in the Northwest Territories of the United States. Decades later, those territories became several new states and tilted the balance of power against the slave states, setting the stage for the abolition of slavery nationwide. I tell you this story because people from small cities and towns all over America, Beverly included, do things small and large to impact the world around us. So as you all move on from Beverly High School to chase your dreams and build your own adult lives, please do not see limits in your opportunities to make a difference. Many of you will travel and live your lives far and wide. Many more will either always call Beverly home or eventually you'll make your way back. No matter where you go, please know that you can make a difference in this world and in the lives of others. For some of us, that opportunity may be more local, on a more intimate scale. For others, like Nathan Dane, that opportunity may be historic and may change the course of our nation and our world. And whichever it may turn out to be for you, you will matter in others' lives. With this in mind, I wish you all the good fortune, good health, and happiness this world can bring. For today, be happy, be proud, celebrate with your friends and fellow graduates. And as you do, please take some time today and in the coming days to really think of all the people who have brought you to today. Be sure to thank those who love and support and believe in you, for they are your family. Our families take all shape and sizes, and whatever your family looks like, make time to thank them and give them all a great big hug and a kiss. Yes, in front of your friends. Seeing you soar today is making their hearts full. Give them that hug and give them that kiss and feel their love. It is what matters most of all. Congratulations, BHS graduates of the class of 2017. Today, the day and the world are yours.
Good afternoon. Isn't it great to be outside? I would like to extend a warm welcome from the Central Office administrators and staff to Mayor Cahill, School Committee President Chris Silverstein, school committee members and elected officials, to Ms. Taylor, the administrators, teachers, and staff of Beverly High School and the Beverly Public Schools, to parents, guardians, family, friends, and of course, the graduating class of 2017. While this is a notable day for all of us, it is your day. There will be other notable days to come in your life, but this one has a special place in acknowledging your accomplishments of the past 13 years. As a former high school principal, this day and the pomp and circumstance remain very special to me. This is my 43rd year as an educator, but graduation never gets old. This is exciting. Your robes symbolize all your hard work and commitment to your education. They symbolize the work of all of the teachers and staff who have committed their lives to helping you achieve your goals. They symbolize the hard work and commitment of your families to your success. And additionally, they really look good. Over the past several years, we have heard how special a class this really is. Your participation in co- and extracurricular activities, academic performance, leadership, and community service have set a new standard for senior classes at Beverly High. We want to thank you for enriching our lives as we witnessed your growth and achievement throughout the years. Listening to the serious way you approached your senior internship was just the most recent example. I heard from many of you about your future hopes and aspirations. In some cases, your internship explored further what you hope to do in the future. In other cases, it was an internship that explored something that had always been an interest. In each case, your serious approach helps define your next steps following high school. Congratulations for your efforts. The world you will enter will provide many opportunities. We know you will have to be self-motivated, hardworking, adaptive, creative, and above all, be able to recognize the right opportunity. The pace of change in the workplace is accelerating. Knowing yourself well will help you find the opportunities that are best for you. This includes knowing what you are good at, as well as knowing what you're passionate about. Opportunities are interesting. Some are easy to spot, others sneak up on you, and still others need to be created. Everyone can and will give you advice. Listen politely, ask questions, and if the opportunity is interesting, ultimately follow your own heart in the end. To quote Mark Twain, or many others who have taken credit for this quote, find a job you enjoy doing, and you will never have to work a day in your life. I know that at your age, I had no intention of becoming a teacher. I majored in mathematics and minored in education as a backup. When I student taught, I was struck by the opportunity the classroom offered. The opportunity was to work in a profession that made a difference. It also was different every class, every day. I never look back and have no regrets. As you leave graduation today, stop and thank someone who helped you be ready for today. You've heard that from a lot of people, but it's very important. There are many to choose from: your family, your parents, your teachers and administrators, your friends, and your community. As you know, Beverly is special and will always be a place called home, no matter where you seek your opportunity. You are a product of this community and you are a representative of this community. Today, Beverly is proud of the class of 2017. You are our future, and I believe our future is in good hands. I wish the world was a safer place than it is, but I hope as you become leaders, you find a way to build a safer society. Good luck, find the right opportunities, and above all, stay safe. Congratulations again, and thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. I would like to thank Dr. Hershey, Ms. Taylor, administrators, teachers, family, friends, and most importantly, the class of 2017. Congratulations to all of my fellow classmates. You are so close to getting your diplomas and never having someone from Beverly High ever lecture you ever again. So here we are. Graduation is such a big step. It's such a big step that it's really impossible to summarize all of high school in one speech. To be honest, I didn't really know what to say. I thought of all of the possible extended metaphors to describe this entire experience, but I couldn't. I mean, what do you even put in a salutatorian speech? What does the position even call for? According to Urban Dictionary, the salutatorian is merely the person who just missed valedictorian by a few GPA points. A very miserable person indeed. Second place is just the first loser. I really hope you all don't think that about me. But according to Urban Dictionary and my place as an inexperienced 17-year-old girl, I can't really give much advice. Rather, it's much better to reflect. I received a letter in the mail about a week ago that recalled many memories. In seventh grade, my English teacher at Briscoe told us to write a letter to ourselves, something we'd want to read our senior year. When I read it, I loved looking back at the memories made, but at the same time, reading it was really embarrassing. It's strange how I was able to feel like I knew everything at that age, and looking back, seeing that I knew nothing at all. But it showed me how far we've come. I can imagine many of you felt the same way as you entered Beverly High School. At the time, you felt like you were right. Like all the parents, the advice your parents and siblings gave you were outdated and void. We've learned the hard way that most of the time they were right. You're a little too headstrong, but that's okay. If there's anything you get out of high school, it's how to learn. Learning, not just academically, but socially, allowed you to change. This environment taught you that you weren't as invincible as you thought you were. In the classroom, teachers expected more out of you than you expected of yourselves. Our teachers pushed us to do better and gave us more than we can handle. In your own lives, you had to deal with loss, heartbreak, and overall just plain old teenage angst. Outside of the school, political turmoil and unrest has racked our minds as well. We felt like the world is changing so fast and we've worried on how to keep up. But this type of social learning is a duality. Even though it made you feel small, your ability to overcome has taught you that you do belong in some special place in this world, even if you haven't found it yet. Internally, there was a driving force inside of you that forced you to overcome this pressure. Even when you felt like giving up and contemplated on why you even bothered, you still put that extra of work in, because a part of you felt like you had to care. Somewhere in the midst of studying all night, taking care of your siblings, going to practice, and working your part-time job, you changed, and for the better. All of this leads me to conclude that change is a good thing. There has definitely been some kind of miraculous change that has occurred in all of us these past years. We entered high school a little bit weird, immature, and still in that awkward stage of puberty. No matter how weird-looking and naive you were when you entered high school, I can tell that all the classmates sitting right in front of me today, that they are so incredibly good-looking, intelligent, ambitious, and incredible people. When you graduate and move on with your lives, whether it be the military, straight into the workforce, or to college, just remember that these are definitely not your glory days, and definitely not the best 4 years of your life. Please don't treat this day as an ending. You all have the ability to do so much better. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Dr. Hershey, Mayor Cahill, Mrs. Taylor, faculty, family, and friends. My name is Andrew King, and it is an honor to be addressing you today. And now, congratulations to my classmates, Beverly High's class of 2017. Today is a day we have all worked hard for, and from here we all go our separate ways. Some to the military, some to the workforce, and most of us will pause briefly before continuing our formal education. Up until this point, we have all had to satisfy the same requirements to cross the stage today. In addition, we have each made individual choices to be involved in activities that we were passionate about, including choices about how we spend our time and who we spend it with. As we move forward, our choices will serve to define each of us even more than they have thus far. In many ways, I would like to suggest to you that our lives are somewhat like older Lego sets. The original Lego sets had instructions that were often extremely difficult to follow. It was your job to look at the picture, try to figure out what had changed from the previous step, find the appropriate pieces, and attach them. Our lives could be looked at in a similar fashion. During high school, we had basic instructions. We had to take a certain number of classes each year in various subjects in order to graduate. Each of us put together unique schedules and extracurricular activities, impacting how we think and preparing us for what comes next. To get to this point, we have managed to follow the basic steps. Just like the first steps in Lego instructions, things have not been overly difficult or complex, and it has been fairly clear how to approach each step and how to measure success. Today, however, we are at a transition point. From here, the directions are not quite as clear as they have been. We can continue to follow the directions in the kit, or we can make our own models. As we look at the Lego pieces remaining, we can organize them as we may, sorting by color or size to get the specified piece, or just grabbing whatever happens to catch our eye and building as we see fit. There are endless possibilities about how the pieces before us can be put together. and this determines who we become. In the future, there will be points where we can connect our pieces with someone else and build something even more complicated, and times when we can choose to build our own model independent of others. There will be opportunities to remove pieces from our model and select something else to replace them. If the piece we want is not available, we can even fabricate it ourselves. All of these choices can be exciting, but also daunting as we look forward. Each of us can approach our future choices with confidence because of the foundation we have from our experiences here at Beverly High. Be creative and confident in your abilities as you begin to model yourself into who you will become, but remember to enjoy the journey and live life along the way. As you make your plan, I encourage you to think of what film producer Jerry Zucker once said. Nothing ever happens in the future. Whatever now. So live your life where the action is, now. Enjoy this day. Celebrate. Congratulations to the Beverly High Class of 2017.
Thank you. afternoon, class of 2017, parents, friends, grandparents, teachers, faculty, and administration. On behalf of the Beverly School Committee, congratulations on your graduation day. It's an achievement of which you should all take great pride. You have worked tirelessly to be in these chairs today. Many of you have immersed yourselves in sports, theater, art, music, ROTC, DECA, and any of the other many clubs here at Beverly High. You may be feeling excited, relieved, petrified, apprehensive, settled, nostalgic, joyful, and proud. All of your excited yet anxious feelings about graduation are completely normal. Overall, there is no normal way to feel. While some of your friends may be itching to move on, it's perfectly okay if you're feeling like you'd like to just stay right where you are. You're at a crossroads in your life. Some of you have chosen a definite path to travel, and others are still undecided, and that's okay. Your job right now is to explore the possibilities and see what's out there for you. At some point, we all make our own way. So maybe you've made a decision about work or travel or volunteering or college or whatever your next step is. And maybe you have not, but you are intelligent people who are leaving Beverly High with the tools to figure it out and make your way in the world. So here is my wish for you, dear class of 2017, that you will always remember the lessons that you learned since you were growing up here and at Beverly High. To work hard, to take risks, to make mistakes, to persevere, to engage your curiosity, to protect our Mother Earth, and to be kind to one another. I wish that you rely on what you learned in your team and group activities, that no one person achieves anything alone. A lone tuba player does not make an entire orchestra. The catcher is not the only person on a baseball team. The leading lady does not make the whole play. They are all very important players, but it takes all of the instruments, the entire team, the whole ensemble to work together to accomplish great things. I also wish that you will always have kindness in your hearts, that when you see someone in need, you are willing to help, and that you have the potential to make a difference in other people's lives. I wish that you will remember to think about how you can contribute to make the world a better place, that you know that you can always count on your Beverly roots and the people who were beside you and guided you along the way to be here for you when you need them, and that you will always find your way home to Beverly. Finally, to everyone who is here with you today, in the bleachers cheering you on, at home watching on BevCam, and those who are with you in spirit who might be far away, you have been a support to the graduates that brought them to these seats, so cheers to all of you. Today, as you embark on the next steps of your lives, as talented, accomplished artists, athletes, scholars, musicians, advocates, teachers, and more, we are also very proud of you and look forward to watching you make your mark in the world. Be well and be safe. Congratulations, class of 2017.
Good afternoon, Dr. Hershey, Mayor Cahill, members of the school committee, parents and guests, and members of the class of 2017. It's a great privilege for me to serve as your principal for your senior year and to be able to speak to you during this commencement ceremony. At every graduation ceremony, a speaker extols the specialness of the graduation class. I am not going to say that this was the best senior class ever. But that's because there's alumna from the other senior classes in the audience. But you guys know the truth. I can say this. This class of 2017 is a class of great spirit. You are a perfect example of what Panther Pride means. That sense of respect for yourself, for others, for your community. You stand up and show up. And I'm going to ask you to do some standing up today. You'll see in a moment. It's kind of a seventh inning stretch. I will not ask you to sing Sweet Caroline. Your academic accomplishments are many. This class has produced 2 National Merit Commended students and 4 Advanced Scholars with Distinction. 2 seniors have received Advanced Academic Endorsements. 76 members of this class are part of the National Honor Society. 92 members of this class are John and Abigail Adams Scholarship recipients. This commitment to academic success is impressive. It's the main purpose of our high school. And I'd like to ask all those students to stand up and be recognized. National Merit Commended Students, Advanced Placement Scholars, John and Abigail Adams recipients, National Honor Students. Please stand. Thank you. Throughout the school year, seniors have challenged themselves and developed their creative spirit. 39 students competed in the DECA International Career Development Conference in Anaheim, California. Our robotics team made it to the quarterfinals in the first robotics competition. Seniors have received gold and silver keys in the Scholastic Art Awards. Our music students competed in the Mic of Music competitions and received gold and silver medals. Several students received all-star awards from the Massachusetts State Drama Festival for their work in performance and production. This class has consistently used their creative skills and talents to compete in various fields, including high school quiz bowl, media, mathematics, and science. Could all the students who are involved in these competitions please stand? DECA, Scholastic Arts, Music, stand up, people, and take a bow. Thank you. This class has shown its drive and energy in athletics. The boys' soccer team made it to the sectional finals, led by Coach Leahy in his last season of 17 years of coaching. The football team were North sectional champions, led by Coach Morenci in his first year of coaching at Beverly High School. Our girls' gymnastic team continued their consecutive winning streak with 65 consecutive wins and placing 8th in the state championship. We have an all New England wrestler in this class, as well as the Salem News Athlete of the Year. Our baseball, softball, girls lacrosse, boys and girls tennis teams competed in the state tournaments. And our boys lacrosse team will be moving on to the semifinals of the North Sectionals next week. Our senior athletes have displayed the ideals of athletic competition, positive and respectful teamwork. Any senior that participated in the Beverly High School athletic program, please stand. Thank you. You've been active Beverly citizens contributing to your community. Key Club and Conservation Club members have cleaned up the beaches at Dame Street and Lynch Park. ROTC cadets have assisted at the pancake breakfast at the Victoria Rocky Post and raked front yards and shoveled driveways. The senior club brought together members of this senior class with members of the senior center for monthly conversations. Peer leaders have provided free daycare for Beverly kids. You participated in the polar plunge to raise money for local community groups. You slept on the field house floor and spent the night raising money for the American Cancer Society. You've participated in many fundraising efforts, including Toys for Tots, Breast Cancer Awareness, and the Good Friday Walk. And you rallied the school together to support 2 Beverly High School staff members as they battled cancer with demonstrations of support and care. Seniors who committed to community service through your senior year through these various clubs and organizations or programs, please stand. Thank you. You're a class we can be proud of. You have effective school leaders with your class officers and student council representatives that I'll ask to stand to get their thanks from their classmates. Student council also. Thank you. We have 8 international students who have joined this class for their senior year and will return to their countries with a bit of Beverly in their hearts. Could you please stand so your classmates may wish you well? I have not listed every single accomplishment of the members of this class. I have not spoken of all the groups who have contributed to the culture of this school. I've not highlighted the small moments, the kindnesses, the time, the extra unseen efforts that so many of you have given to this community. Many of you will go to college in the fall. Some of you will join the job market right away, and some of you will be taking a gap year exploring opportunities. Other members of this class will be serving in our nation's military. I would ask those seniors who are planning to enter the military to stand so you can be acknowledged by your classmates. Thank you. Because you all embody Panther pride, that sense of self-respect and respect for others and regard for your community, you, better than anyone else, understand that your accomplishments would not have been possible without the support and guidance of others. The Beverly High School faculty is proud of you and proud that they had the opportunity to instruct and mentor you. I know you appreciate your teachers' efforts on your behalf. The greater Beverly community has invested in this high school with their tax dollars, but also with their devotion to the school. They know that their support of education will only help to improve the city of Beverly. Your family, particularly your parents and guardians, have waited for this day. They, better than anyone else, know your struggles and your successes. They invested in your past, and they are committed to your future. Please stand and join me in thanking them for all they have done. Thank you, parents. I do hope you grew and flourished here at Beverly High School. I hope you felt safe and secure here. I hope you discovered your talents, met your challenges, explored new ideas, gained friends, and became a better person for being here. But I want more for you. I want you to move on and go forward, to take that Panther pride into the world, into new experiences. The world needs you to continue to stand up for yourself, for your community, and for all the people who cannot stand up for themselves. I know you can do it. You did it here. Thank you, class of 2017. Mrs. Silverstein, it is now my pleasure to present the graduating class of Beverly High School 2017.
Samuel Edward Abatey. Sydney Elizabeth Abramovich. Kyle James Achavati. Alton Orhan Adelolu. Ashley Ann Adams. Heather Marie Adams. Thomas Charles Adams. Student Council Member Madison Ames Aitken. Kenji Alamilo. Emily Louise Aldrich. Alyssa Marie Alexander. Diane Alhafez. Student Council Treasurer, Alexis Marie Alley. Ian James Alpine. Rowan Farazdak Al-Salawi. Zach Vahan Ananian. Tessa Marie Armbruster. Kayla Ann Artis. Christopher Emil Baez. Javier Orlando Baez. Thomas Jacob Bass. Morgan Bauermeister. Emma Rose Bodwin.
I got you.
Austin Michael Bolia. Catherine Rose Bolia. Sylvia Bellamini. Daniel Antonio Bencourt. David Antonio Bencourt. Madison Rose Bibbo. Grace Bailey Biggis. Maeve Ellen Tracy Blake. Claudio Boca. Mackenzie Paige Bolas. Najet Rania Bufares. Brian Robert Bowden. Lauren Jones Bromley. Zoe Leanne Bromley. Nia Cherry Brown. Joseph William Breuer. Grace Caroline Bird. Catherine Rose Cafferty. Hugh Jeffy Callis. James Matthew Calitri. Martha Jane Callahan. Natan Ribeiro Campos. Colin McDonald Carboni. Jalen Victoria Carter. David Carlton Cassie. Benjamin Charles Casola. Jacksenia Castillo. Tyler Paul Castingway. Molly Ann Cecil. William Austin Center V. Elias Jonas Chambers. Kyle Joseph Champlain. Brendan Christopher Chan. Kyle Scott Chenard. Jared David Clarizia. Congrats. Justin Robert Cloyd. Brianna Elizabeth Coe. Christopher Matthew Cole. Caroline Elizabeth Collins. Peter Conti Colantino. Colleen Elizabeth Consoli. William A. Coombs. Alexander Taylor Copeland. Ryan Thomas Copeland. Vasily Billy Katsani.
Hey, Billy!
Natalie Warren Coughlin. Corinne Renee Colts. Alyssa Lynn Croft. Catherine Marie Cross. Edward Theodore Crowley. Luis Manuel Cruz. John Mark Cuoco. Jillian Ann Kewick. Jeffrey Michael Daly.
Riz Bailey De Jesus. Nicholas Alexander De Silvestri. Bismel Sarai Diaz. Nicholas Robert DeLuiso. Sydney Joe Dominic. Ishbel Marion Donegan. William Gerald Dooling. Kristen Nicole Doucette. Luke Joseph Dunbar. Celia Ryan Eanes. Mark Araceli Eckborg. Adam Richard Ellis. Matthew Vincent Enos. Meredith McKinnon Enright. Annalise DeLuca Errico. George Cole Fafard. John Joseph Filoni. Leo Jacob Feingold. Ludovica Vittoria Finolo. Trenton Joseph Fiore. Emily Jasmine Firpo. Lila Cherie Fish. Caroline Taylor Forbes. Catherine Rose Furtado. Thomas Brody Franciscato. Michaela Iris Frangos. Samuel John Friedman. Keenan Joseph Furlong. Alana Marie Gabriel. Sydney Rose Gallagher. Madison Lee Gauthier. Patrick William Gavin. Maya Shaloisa Genitelli. Mary Catherine Giles. Wiley Grace Goddard. Haley Marie Ganeau. Kelly Nicole Goodall. Sean Matthew Goodwin. Anthony Tyler Grande. Misael Gratini. Kayla Lynn Green. Ashish Gurung. Samita Gurun. Trevor John Habon. Molly Elaine Hamer. Brian Armand Hardy. Sophia Ruth Hutala. Alan Arthur Hawks. Jane Tenney Healy. Marceline Hernandez. Andrea Michelle Higgins. Austin Charles Higgins. Amber Elizabeth Hobbs. Ashley Nicole Hopkins. Sarah Jean Hopkins. Scott Joseph Hoyt. Megan Rose Huntoon. Kendra Lee Huth. Benjamin Kossoff Ingelson. John Michael Jacobson. Nicholas Richard Gelbert. Timothy William Johnson. Andrew Hale Johnstone. John Paul Jones III. Megan Ann Kane. Chloe Ann Kavanaugh. Julia Rose Kelly. Sarah Ann Kelly. Jake Michael Kelty. Andrew Stephen King. Melanie Rose Kirsch. Vanessa Katova.
An Pham Klein. Charlotte Lynn Knowlton. Julio Chiole. Ali Jenna Kramer. Daniel Benjamin Krendel. Joshua Michael Krendel. Got it. Siddhartha Lage. You made it. Darren George LaPierre. Sean Ryan Leahy. Ciliana Rosalyn Leon. Kadriana Ali Letts. Nathan Philip Long. Sophia Maria Larrera. Lauren Wilson Luvanda. Daniel Joseph Lynch. Colin Timothy McDonald. Kara Irene McGilvery. Tyler Reed Maker. Matthew Duncan Manzo. Tyler Justin Mardi Gras. Chad Edward Mariscalchi. Hannah Lee Mariscalchi. Zachary Scott Matthews. Samuel Patrick Matson. Taryn Xavier Timothy Mazzaglia. Darcy Caroline McAuliffe. Megan Catherine McDonald. Jacob Henry McLaughlin. Daniel Dylan McNulty. Brian Michael McPherson. Spencer Thomas Meehan. Natalie Rose Mellinger. Sarah Ray Michu. Daniel John Miley. Joseph Samuel Modal. Madison Adeline Monahan. Nora Stone Monahan. Austin James Morin. Nicholas Andrew Morley. Andrew James Morris. Alec Lee Muse. Your student council president, Oliver Lee Muse. Margaret Mary Mulligan. Key Keegan Thomas Mullins. Abby Elizabeth Murphy. Dylan Timothy Malott Murphy. Alexi Mercedes Negron. Julia Ruth Noel. Jacob Manuel Nolasco. Andrea Karen Nunez. Brittany Ann Nyman. Eleanor Kathleen Ofeisch. Yeah. Nicole Marie Ofeisch. Kyle Stewart Oliveira. Sebastian Tyromina Ortega. Michael William Ostrowski. Ruth Tamara Osiak. Nicholas Joseph Palermo. Jordan Joseph Paul Parasilla. Diana Lise Jacqueline Pena. McKenna Grace Perkins. Zachary Reuben Perkins. Julia Marie Perry. Simon Yates Peterson. Nathan Thomas Phillips. Jacqueline Christine Pia. Jessica Taylor Pike. Tyrese Yalen Pimentel Soto. Jillian Quinn Pinciaro. Michael Joseph Pinter. Matthew Robert Pittman. John Noel Pettimiglio. Jean Clary Pivigier.
Devin Rose O'Brien Powers. Samuel Joseph Prince. Brady Francis Reddy. Devin Wayne Reed. Jackson James Reed. Devin Richard Reeves. Madison Rose Rennie. Samantha Jane Rennie. Kate Giselle Resnick. Justin Michael Rush. Joy Divine Richardson. Sean Matthew Richardson. Noah Evan Robinson. Yurelis Rodriguez. Leona Jesse Rostock. Madison Rose Rotundo. Robert Stephen Rowe. Corinne Mary Roy. Gabriella Rushi. Adriana Elise Ryan. John Francis Ryan. Sammy Ashraf Sahul. Gabrielle Catherine Solis. Luke Anthony Samperi. Kayla Nicole Santerre. Sean Michael Sarantis. Victoria May Schacht. Benjamin George Schlegel. Alexa Rashida Schnann. Jonathan Craig Schuster. Ryan Lauterbach Scolio. Michaela Brina Shaberik. Nicholas Alfred Shares. Christian Connor Short. Luke Philip Singer. Julie Grace Saroy. Piper Madison Slattery. Marita Ann Smallman. Jillian Dana Smith. Laciana Sone Smith. Grace Elizabeth Sparkman. Student Council Vice President Kayleen Grace Spur. Bradley James Spillert. Samuel Hamer Stavis. Nicholas Creston Steege. Anastasia Marie Steigers. Emma Catherine Sudak. Alexis Anna Sutak. Matthew George Swindell. Rachel Marie Tanzella. Jasmine Steen Tejada. Emma Lee Thomas. Jake Andrew Thomas. Rebecca Lynn Thorpe. Allie Shane Tilton. Skylar Ann Terrell. Erica Christine Torkeldsen. Joseph Ryan Trachea. Kimberly Tran. Tao Mong Trin. Henry Lewis Tusco. Thomas Edward Urbanski. James Patrick Yusevich. Thomas Evan Vaccaro. Robert Jacob Veal. Anne Margaret Von Zweck. Konstantin Alexander Vostrikov. Ryan Allen Walker. Abigail Lynn Walsh. Brendan Elson Ward. Trenton Thomas Weaver. Will Murphy Weingartner. Amanda Beth Wenzel. Marissa Ann West. Rosemary Elizabeth Wilkinson. Malcolm Richard Zaroka. Mike Zhang. Alessia Roxanne Zorzan. Samantha Maria Zawisco.
And the treasurer of the class of 2017, Amanda Joan Rosenberger!
And the secretary of the class of 2017, Kevin Patrick Flaherty.
The vice president of the class of 2017, Krista Nicole Kamara.
Lastly, ladies and gentlemen, the president of the class of 2017, Kevin Joseph Morenci.